Hi, we have a circle here. Two semicircles, this and this, have been placed inside the circle in a way that the diameters of the semicircles are chords to the circle, and these two semicircles are tangent to each other at this point. If the area of the circle is 1 square units, what's the area of the shaded regions? This question has also appeared on Mr. Press Talwalkar's channel. Mr. Talwalkar has a great channel. I love his contents. But he has mentioned a long method to solve this problem. I'll reveal a magical method to solve this. And as the name suggests, it's really magical. Do pause the video if you'd like to solve it yourself. So, we are going to use the method of considering extreme cases to solve this problem. Because the question has not specified how big or small the semicircles are, what we do is to reduce the size of any one of the semicircles, say the upper one, like this. Even upon doing this, the question will still remain the same. Now, we'll reduce it a bit more. And a bit more. And a bit more. And we'll go on reducing until its radius becomes zero. Or in other words, until the semicircle becomes a point. Remember, upon doing this, we have not been violating any conditions set by the question. So, as you can see, the bottom semicircle has now come to fit the half of the bigger circle. Meaning, the area of the shaded regions, which is now the area of the bigger semicircle, is half the area of the circle. Because the area of the circle is 1 square units, the area of the shaded regions is half square units, or 0.5 square units. That's it! Wasn't it interesting? Now, one thing to take note is, we should cautiously apply this concept of extreme cases. We can apply it only if we know that the question has a definite answer within the information provided. For instance, would we use this concept if any of the semicircles was a triangle or a circle, so as to speak? We could not, because in that case, there would not be a definite answer to the question, as the information provided in the video would be insufficient. In that case, we would need at least an extra information in the question. For example, the height at which the semicircle and the triangle or circle intersect, or other details. Hope you liked the video. Like and subscribe for more videos and magical methods.